And we come now to the last instrument I'll be briefly talking about. It's a kind of instrument which in a way is representative almost of the Middle Ages in the imagination of everyone, and it's of course the bagpipes. It's an instrument that can be found in so many different configurations and types and pitches in practically the whole world. In the European Middle Ages, there must also have been plenty of different types of bagpipes. There aren't that many archaeological finds that can be attributed to bagpipes, unfortunately. There is possibly a chanter from the Netherlands that may have belonged originally to a bagpipes, but there isn't that much. On the other hand, we have an enormous amount of iconography representing bagpipes, and some of that iconography is plainly reliable as a way of making hypotheses as to how how a medieval bagpipes might have worked. So what I have here is essentially a speculative reconstruction of bagpipes from the central Middle Ages, 13th, 14th century. It has a simple chanter and only one drone. We can see again from iconography that there were bagpipes without any drones, or very often with only one shoulder drone, sometimes more rarely and slightly later in time, two drones, and eventually even more than that. I'll be playing another tune from the manuscrit du Roi, the King's Songbook, from which I played an estampie earlier. I'm going to play a dance on this reconstruction of a medieval bagpipes that was made by an Italian craftsman called Corrado Perazzo. Just a curiosity about the wood, the timber from which it was made. This is olive timber, and it's very likely indeed that medieval craftsmen used local wood to make their instruments, and so we decided to use a type of wood which is excellent actually for making instruments, and which would have been entirely native to northern Italy then, just like now. So, dance from the King's Songbook, the Chansonnier du Roi, from about 1300.